Hello, everybody. Reggie Time here, and I've been having a bad day. I initially set out more than half an hour ago, maybe 45 minutes ago, to explore some AAA reg tables, only to find that they still have the fucking really terrible bug that they've had for, well, as long as I can remember, over 10 years. The whole, that anyone who's familiar with AAA will know this bug. Why they cannot or do not fix it is fucking beyond me. But it's like, it's the one where you go to join a table, it tells you that this table is reserved for another player, and then it just doesn't let you fucking join it, and then it's just fucking really annoying. So I couldn't get on fucking tables. And I was getting on tables and every fucking seat was reserved, so no cunt else could join. Like, oh, just fuck off. So like, fuck it. I've got money on there now. Let's just do fucking some snap and be a massive hypocrite. And now I can't get my fucking hood to work. So yeah, basically it's been a cunt of a day. And I swore in the first 1 minute of a YouTube video, so it probably won't like that. Couldn't give a fuck, to be honest with you. So we're going to basically play some Snap, which I don't like playing because it's full of fucking nits without a hood. So this could go badly. Good thing is we've only got $100 on the site, so that's all I can fucking lose. My default assumptions on everyone's just going to be fucking shite nit, unless I have reason to think otherwise. Let's see if I can chill out a little bit and try and have some fun. Now, I know this guy's definitely a fucking nit. We're just going to... Default assumption's going to be nit. And we're just going to try and play solid poker based on how I would play against nits. Don't know, we're waiting here for the queen four. The really sad thing is I don't have to do anything for the next hour and a half, so this might end up being an hour and a half session of fucking purgatory for me, because I'm determined to get a video out. I'm fucking determined to get a video out of this no matter what. So yeah, could be a fucking disaster. This cunt 3xing under the gun. Unhappy defend. Pretty reasonable flop for our big blind defending range. Not the worst flop for our hand either. Fuck this guy. We're going to go with the check raise. Absolutely snap calls. There is a man who's got a big pocket pair or a flush draw. Way more likely he's just got a big pocket pair. Going to give up on this particular turn card against this particular opponent because he is an absolute... What is that? What is that size? It's an absolute fucking mess of a poker player. So we just happily fold against him. Three betting the jerks against someone I'm not at all familiar with, flopping top boat, which is nice. I'm going to continue with a relatively small bet here. Plenty of ways he can have some interaction with this board. Let's just hope he has. Turn is a complete break. Obviously, we lose to 10 now. That's all we lose to. If he's got that, then good for him. What size do I want to use here? Do we want to have overbet here? I think we top set, probably not. What size do I want to go, though? We want to get all in by the river, don't we? 20 bigs? Is Seem reasonable. Calls. What an absolutely diabolical river. I just don't think we can shove this anymore. Like, any 10 beats as backdoor flushes beaters, can we shove it? What does he call with? Yeah, when he checks, I think we can just shove it. Is it too thin? Soon find out. Yeah, it was too thin. What is that? That's disappointing. Knew I couldn't shove that river. That is disappointing. Was it too thin? I mean, the guy's obviously a, like, 24 carat fucking moron, so maybe it's not too thin against 24 carat morons. We'll check that with the wizard later, but it's the wizard's not going to understand people who call 10-8 off 2-3 bets out of position. But we'll see. Three bet the pocket eights here. Ace queen against champ. See what champ wants to do about it. Champ wants to check back. Now we're just going to bet twice. No, we're not. We're going to bet once. Squeezed here. We're going to want to fold a lot, and now we're definitely going to want to fold. I mean, if this isn't a premium holding, I will give somebody $50 in the chat. Come on, treat Tiagi, a fucking weapon, get on with it. Trying to check back in a four bet pot, queen high mono. Come on, we've got $50 sweat on here. And then he just goes all in. I mean, what the actual fuck is this? Get back to it, Reg. We never know. Save me $50 at least in case I was wrong. This guy bets and checks turn. Doesn't have a queen. We're going to try and pretend we've got a queen. We're going to bet pot on the turn and we're going to like over bet river. Don't need to. Brad Wonkall. I believe he's pretty decent. Could be wrong. But my understanding is, from memory, that this guy isn't a moron. Let the ace jack go versus a non-moron. Opened. And someone who's either too broke or too moronic to reload. We're going to 3-bet. Maybe he's had one or two too many left hooks to the fucking brain. Chop your stack up, dickhead. Another one. Too shit or too thick to reload. Ace-10 in the bin. I've just got the feeling I'm going to be a bit of a cunt today. I'm not good when my days get off to bad starts. Usually I just should go back to bed and start the day again. I've got a feeling today is not going to be a good day. Very rarely do I feel like if I have a day that gets off to a bad start that it gets like a lot better quickly or a lot better at all. It was like you just want to like, right, forget this day, fast forward to tomorrow. This day's going to be shit. And I get how entitled that makes me sound, because the reason I'm having a shit day is because 10L on 888 was shit and my hood isn't working. I mean, it's not really a bad day, is it, to be honest? It's like fucking grow up, Reg, you entitled fat fanny. But these things are all relative. Oh, yeah, and then getting stacked by 10-8 off when you flop top set. That's not ideal either. Think I'm going to bet this flop. I'm going to use a larger sizing. Not going to bet our ace 10 on the right hand side table against big blind, nor are we going to bet our ace 6 on the left table against big blind. I'm happy just to try and show this ace 10 down. Happy to fold the ace 6. Chop it up, it's unfortunate. It's probably a pip too loose, but fuck it, we're doing it. Called in two spots. Check in, giving up. Multi-way. Hello, aces. Walk me, just to really fucking irritate me even more. Right, this cunt's never going to call a 3-bet. It's very annoying. But whatever, we have to 3-bet still, of course. But if we don't get action from cold brain, we ain't getting action from UK unless he's absolutely top of range. Oh, hello there. Well, hello. We're going to have a trippy here. Just have a call. Hope he hasn't got pocket kings. But we would have lost the same amount of money versus pocket kings regardless if we just jammed pre. Bet the turn. I'm aware we could be getting trapped to fucky. I mean, I don't care that there's a four liner out there. Shouldn't have any of it. Ace 5 would be like the only 4-liner I'm worried about, and we block that pretty fucking hard. Although we don't block the ace 5 of diamonds. Yeah, we're all in, aren't we? That's unfortunate, because we could have like just missed out on stacking something like two queens there by being too much of a prick pre. I do like a trap. Out of position here, we have the ace jack. We're going to check. We are going to check the turn. And call. And we're going to check the river and feel a little bit concerned when our opponent bet. What? You didn't bet that on the river, sir? Fuck me. Well, that saved us some money, hasn't it? What the fuck? Yeah. Yeah, I've got the second up flush, mate. Check. But there's no more streets, mate. You can't put any more money in. There's another card coming. If you don't bet now, that's it. The hand's over. You can't win any more money. Yeah, check anyway. Yeah, but mate, you've got the second up flush. I get the odds paid, but you've got the second up flush. You need to bet. You know, try and make some money. That's fine. What if I get check raised? Yeah, but mate, river check raises are just always the nuts, so you can just easily fold. But what you mean is you don't miss value when you value bet, and then if you get raised, you can just fold your hand. It's not a problem. Nah, just check, I think. I'll just check. Just better be safe than sorry. Can't lose what you don't put in the middle. Fucking prick. Anyways, we've got top pair here. We've got this cold brain who seems to be, like, active. We've been donked into by some... Oh, what the fuck is going on here? We just have a fold, don't we? We have a fold. What's going on, though? What is going on with these two fucking morons? Yeah, cold brain's folding, I think, isn't he? We think the cold brain's folding. Yeah, fuck cold brain. I don't wait any longer. Pretty obvious our hand wouldn't have been the best. And cold brain's just sulking by taking whatever on the river. Defending the 10-8 suited multi-way from the big blind and thinking of some pretty specific flops we might want. That wouldn't be one of them. This is too loose, but we're doing it anyway under the gun. Love to think about playing these sixes, but we have another moron who's too broke or too stupid to play 100 big blinds. Ah. We need to get some good cards. I know we had the aces. They're good cards. We had the top set. They're good cards too. But I want more good cards. Really dislike you in this prick action. We're going to lead the turn. He can check back some hands on that board that are better than ace 10, but we're going to lead. Champ. Okay, we're all in. We're going to dump a stack on you for code UK. Maybe we're not. Hoping a pair against Brad. I'm going to check it back. And also check back the ace 9. Brad bets big on the turn. And we're just going to fold. Here we pick up the flush draw. The board has paired. I'm going to call though. We river a flush. We're going to raise fold when he bets, if he bets. When he doesn't bet, I'm going to bet pretty big here. So I'm going to use 100%. No idea if that was okay or not. But I won the pot. I was contemplating over betting too. Hello, ladies. Are you going to be nice to me? What is this? I have no idea what this is, but we're going to ask you to put some more in. I'm not going to give this cunt action. Queen 9 suited is almost certainly a mandatory defend versus a reasonable small blind 3 betting range. I am firmly of the belief that UK fucking duck for UK or whatever the cunt's called doesn't have a reasonable small blind 3 betting range. So therefore, fuck him. Seabet multi-way, strong, snap call, weak. If he double barrels here, I'll start to get pretty anxious. River two pairs. Probably have the best hand. Hit one third, see what happens. And win. Being a pair versus Bonanza Bros. gonna bet on the larger side here on this board. Relatively unconnected. We get the call and we're gonna shut down. Are we gonna probe this turn? I think we are. And easy fold with the ace four. Nine suited, opening it up. Many callers. Check flop, probably just check folding. Ending the 7-4 suited and flopping two pairs. We're going to race for value here. Our opponent has a king or better. Sadly not. Pocket sixes. We can go either way here. Just gonna fold. Three bet the king nine suited and get a rather delightful flop. sadly, we get no action. Somehow he lets us win with the ace three. I wasn't expecting. Ace nine off. Shouldn't open it. Didn't decide to try and win the pot. Whooping top set. What? Excuse me? Let's invite you to put some more money in. Oh. Please just have a set and not a flush draw. Oh, set over set. How nice. Beautiful. Thank you. Come again soon. Thanks for coming. Bye. Been dunked into. We have too much going on to fold. So we're just going to call the one big blind. 10 of clubs, please. Nope. Don't see how we win this pot. Now I definitely don't see how we win this pot. Three bet in the kings and three bet in the ace queen. All in with the kings. Can't wait to see his pocket aces. The best thing ever. Oh yeah, there it is. Hello aces. What else is new? Someone's four bet and it's aces. Who knew? Who fucking knew? And now we don't have enough money. All of a sudden, we don't have enough money on the site to reload, which is unfortunate. So we're going to have to sit out of this table so we can reload at this table. So we are currently down $16, which is unfortunate. Nine it suited, opening under the gun, getting the small three bet, absolutely hating everything about the spot. He calls, just smash the flop, please, dealer. Oh, well, as if you're not going to smash the flop, just completely brick it, so we don't have to throw any more money into the fire. I mean, this squeeze is like remarkably inappropriately sized. It needs to be a lot bigger from out of the small blind. Just gonna fold, see what this fucking moron's doing. Check back on that in a moment. Did he just take it down with his C bet? I think he probably did. Yeah, he did. I mean, fucking hell, mate. I know you're in a war ravaged country and you're probably not having the best time at the minute, but don't come and play fucking poker with 30 blind stacks. You want to do that, find a fucking tournament, and I wish you all the luck in it, because you know your life's probably fucking shit right now, but don't come at my life shit with your 30 big blind nonsense. Damn, we're not reloading for some reason. Just fucking reload, you prick. Why aren't we reloading? Did I click a button that meant we're not going to reload? It appears that I did. It appears that I clicked a button that means reload isn't going to fucking work. Gabster just decided to stop bluffing, which is unfortunate for him, because it probably would have worked had he done it with his jack five. He just limps the button and lets us win with Queen High. Come on, hurry up. Sit me out so I can get back in. Right, Rich. This time, make sure you fucking click the reload button. Limp calls, we get a pretty miserable flop, but we do have some stuff going on, so we will stab. pretty happy with the situation now. Ace King 10. Don't know what to do here. Don't know what to do. Don't know whether to go for a check raise or just bet again. Go for the check raise, hopefully allow him to like bet an ace king, sorry, an ace queen, ace jack type hand. That doesn't work. Bomb the river. Let's see what he had. Ace queen, just flat pre, just flat flop, check back turn. As it happens, he lost the minimum, but still pretty fucking annoying. This might be really, really bad. We've got the limp and then we've got like the weak looking ISO, which is why I've done it. Mostly because of the weak looking ISO. Flopping a flush draw here in two overs, getting donked into. I'm just going to like, try and push my equity right now, rather than call and then see like a brick turn and get confused. Feels like a pretty minute. Donked out of the big blind. Called a raise, and then we get that turn card. Doesn't feel like a turn card I want to continue like pushing the action on. Doesn't feel like a turn card I want to barrel. And then he throws something. And then we hit a river that might end up costing us money. I'm going to go for some value here and hate my life if we get raised because we just can't call. We won the pot. Got a bit lost in that hand. was hoping he just folded or just fucking wanted to get it in on the floor. Imagine versus flop get it in range, you're probably in pretty rough shape. Perhaps our raise needs to be bigger, like force him into like a... Imagine, I think the bigger we raise, the more we force him into going all in, maybe the worse that is for us. The nice thing about having no hoodies is that you see all these players with like less than 100 bigs and you're like, oh, these games might be good. And then you're not reminded that they're fucking dog shit when you see these cunts playing like fucking 18/7. And so that's at least one thing. Look at that. Ooh, symmetry. We've got a gut shot here, so we're not going to fall, but we're not particularly hopeful that this hand's going to end positively for us. 0% chance I attempt to bluff this guy. Not a huge fan of 3-betting these 50 big blind fucking wank stands. But we've done it. We've flopped a gutter ball. Dunked into, which is an interesting line. And every bone in my body wants to just rip this in, but we're not going to. Old school Reggie would have ripped this in a fucking heartbeat, wouldn't have thought twice about it. New school Reggie is just gonna fold the turn. We can be one last shot to hit a deuce. And sadly, it didn't come. Who knows if our flop jam would have worked. Bonanza Brothers leading this flop, as is his right. Not sure he gets to lead it as much versus cut up as perhaps he thinks he does, but we got King High, so why do I care? C-bet in the king, sorry, queen 9-4 against a small blind flat. He does find the call, and he just leads the turn. I'm just having a hard time believing this guy. Going to be a punt coming in here. Going to be a punt incoming. Raise the turn. Andy folds, yeah, no idea what that fucking line was by him. I mean, my race was just a total punt, but I'm like, really, mate? You want to check call lead? And you flatted the small blind, which I know is becoming more of a thing in GTO world. Check call flop, lead turn. I can understand why maybe you would want to take that line with some of your big blind holdings, but not your small blind ones. I could be completely fucking way off there. But it just looked to me there like that was just someone trying, like misapplying a concept and probably just messing themselves up. So I tried to exploit that. And we flopped top set again. We've squeezed here versus Bonanza Boy. We've flopped pretty well. Up here on the turn, the five isn't ideal in terms of like some straights get there, but not enough for me to give a fuck. So we're going to bet again. That's my ass falling out with this ace king because I don't really know what to fucking do. So we just do the shit rig half pot thing. Triple Eight appears to be lagging, which is pretty fucking annoying. Definitely freaking out a little bit. It's Triple Eight here. It's definitely having a bit of a wobble. As long as it doesn't affect us in a meaningful pot, I'll just live with it. Ace 10 off, probably a slam dunk open under the gun. Not in my world. Hello, ladies. Okay, and we went all in. And just hope Dombrick isn't at the top of his range. Dombrick hasn't snapped, that's good news. The ace in the flop isn't good news. Never mind. We were just clawing our way back as well, weren't we? Just clawing our way back. And some moron who just doesn't want to play anymore. Three bet jams. Ace 10 off because he's shit and he doesn't want to play. Then he's rewarded by getting there. And you're just like, all right, okay. Reggie's moody Tuesday is going to continue to be a moody Tuesday. Woe is me. Ace 7 suited versus cutoff. I don't know. So we're just going to hit the 3 bet button. Ace 10 from middle position is something I will open, but I'm always glad just to take it down. That is not our flop, and this guy does this, which I don't think can be correct, but who cares? Cold brain might be going for a delayed C bet line here. Six encourages me now that we might have some showdown value, but deep down, I know we don't. I know we don't win this hand with six with our pair of sixes. We might win it with our trip sixes. A pretty easy raise fold here. Do I think this guy checks full houses twice? Probably not. Do I think he checks a flush twice? Maybe. Definitely prefer playing this game without a HUD. But when I play on party where there is no HUD, I don't enjoy it as much. I think probably because party software is just absolute fucking AIDS. Checking the ace jack, of course. Probably not folding versus small bets, which he should maybe do quite a bit of on the button. Turn some equity, get led into large by someone I don't fucking know. Where you're from, sir? We don't know. I mean, we're just going to call. And we're going to bet for the river. Interesting flop table two against the blinds. We flopped a pair and a gut shot. Which gives us some hope of winning the pot. Add an open ender. Get led into. Call, fold river unimproved. I guess. Do we now turn our hand into a bluff? That is the question trembling on my lips. Do we turn our hand into a bluff? Yes, I think I want to. So I'm going to. That didn't work. It did work because we somehow won the pot. What the actual fuck? He called me with 7-6. We 2x pot the river as a bluff and we get called by a worse hand. That is nice. That is a highlight reel moment. What on earth? Guess he just put me on clubs. That's cheered me up. That has definitely cheered me up. He snapped too, and like, oh fuck, he snapped. We're dead. All right, he hasn't shown me his cards yet. We're not dead. Flopping well here too. He's just calling my life when it gets back to me. Okay, now it's not the easiest call of my life. Now it's one of the easiest folds of my life. Ace set suited. We're going to flat the button here. No idea what we do with ace set suited typically versus under the gun. But I decided to flat. Do we want to start betting now? I think maybe we do. Try and get some value from under pairs that are just trying to get to showdown. And we're going to bet the river too. And win. Against pocket threes. People don't like folding much, do they? Don't like bluffing and they don't like folding. That's what we're already aware of. But it's been reaffirmed in the last few minutes. And I think we might be winning now. We're not checking. We'll have a lovely surprise at the end of the video. But we've had kings into aces and we've had top set cracked. and we might still be winning. There's meant to be some three betting of this, but fuck it, not doing it. Not doing it. Can go either way here. I think with the ace 10 there's probably going to be a preference in Soberland for one or the other. I don't use a randomizer. I just decide whether I'm going to call or three bet based on how I'm feeling, I guess. Really not happy that the fact he's gone large multi-way, but we can't fold for one bet. Yeah, this guy's just either got a very good hand or he's got like a pretty high equity bluff. This is just like not a good situation for ace 10. It's from the UK, so it's probably shit, but we'll fold. And I guess we go duck hunting here. No duck on the pond. Three bet in the ace four suited versus Brett. I'm taking it down. popping a pair here. Checking it back. Falling the turn like a little fairy. Fold. Popping a top pair. More confident in my hand now, but still don't want to bet. And now we've had a really bad run out, and we're just going to check fold, I guess. Yeah, we don't beat two players. Oh, my wife's coming home. And where's that hand at? We don't know. All right, wifey. Just finishing a video. I was going to finish in 20 minutes, but you've come home and fucking wrecked it, love. You just come home and fucking wrecked all my fun. As usual. As usual, Dono fucking ruins things. Well, I guess we'll sit out next big blind at all cash games. Don't you fucking flick the beast to me, because I will black your eye. And I don't give a fuck. And that's going to be it. Did we win? Did we fuck? We lost. $8. We lost $8, Dawn. Dawn doesn't give a fuck about me losing $8. Pua. Pua. Dawn says pua too. I get taken the piss at me for saying pua and tournaments, Dawn. Do you call it a tournament or a tournament? Tournament. Tournament, see? Tournament, see? Right. I am out of here. As always, fuck the Tories. Fuck speed poker. And, yeah. Ta-ra for now.